Item number, SCP-092. Object class, safe. Special containment procedures. The 3,125 instances of SCP-092 are to be held in individual cases suitable for containing non-anomalous audio compact discs, or CDs, and stored in standard inanimate object lockers at Site 37. Each instance is to be individually numbered with permanent marker. Testing of instances of SCP-092 is to be done in soundproof rooms. Only one instance of SCP-092 may be examined at a time. Only D-Class personnel are to listen to previously unexamined instances of SCP-092. Research proposals which involve non-D-Class personnel listening to instances of SCP-092 require written approval from Site Command. The cadaver of SCP-092-B is not currently considered anomalous, except by association, and is preserved in the morgue freezer at Site 19. Description: SCP-092 is a set of 3,125 audio CDs, each labeled the absolute, 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 absolute best of the fifth dimension, and marked with the names of the 31 performers who have at various times been part of the American singing group The Fifth Dimension. Each instance of SCP-092, when played in a standard CD player, will produce a distinct anomalous effect upon all individuals within hearing range. The anomalous phenomenon will last 74 minutes, the duration of a standard audio CD, during which time listeners will be unable to leave hearing range, or to shut off the CD player, or otherwise interrupt its function. As well, when the anomalous phenomenon finishes, all surviving listeners will engage in synchronized vocalization of the phrase, "Wow, that was real cool." Synchronized vocalization has been observed in non-anglophones, pre-verbal infants, unconscious individuals, paralyzed individuals, and individuals physically incapable of speech due to laryngeal, lingual, and/or buccal damage. The anomalous properties of each instance of SCP-092 are thematically and conceptually linked to the number 5, dimensions, and/or the members of the fifth dimension. As of 871 instances of SCP-092 have been assessed, and their anomalous properties formally described. Representative sample of documented anomalous properties of instances of SCP-092. Instance SCP-092-28. Anomalous property: listeners experience quintuple vision for all moving objects. Instance SCP-092-41. Anomalous property: listeners' bodies exude pentagonal crystals of elemental boron, chemical element number 5. Crystals cease materializing upon conclusion of CD, but do not dematerialize. Instance SCP-092-42. Anomalous property: listeners' bodies exude pentagonal ingots of elemental manganese, chemical element number 25, or 5 to the power of 2. Ingots cease materializing upon conclusion of CD, but do not dematerialize. Listeners succumb to acute manganese poisoning within 24 hours. Instance SCP-092-43. Anomalous property: listeners' bodies exude pentagonal nodules of elemental cesium, chemical element number 55. All listeners killed by cesium burns within 8 minutes. Instance SCP-092-79. Anomalous property: listeners become physiologically 5 years old. Instance SCP-092-80. Anomalous property: listeners become physiologically 5 months old. Instance SCP-092-81. Anomalous property: listeners become physiologically 5 weeks old. Instance SCP-092-82. Anomalous property: listeners become physiologically 5 days old. Instance SCP-092-87. Anomalous property: listeners spontaneously become 5 months pregnant. Pregnancies spontaneously miscarry upon conclusion of CD. In initial tests, all male listeners succumb to massive internal hemorrhaging within 10 minutes, as do 3 female listeners. Surviving female listeners succumb to organ damage within 4 days. Post-mortem genetic analysis shows that all fetuses were identical and are not related to the listeners. Instance, SCP-092-126. Anomalous property. Listeners experience unbearably painful facial spasms, characterized by constant chewing and biting motions. Symptoms of trigeminal neuralgia, caused by inflammation of the fifth cranial nerve. During initial test, all listeners batter themselves into unconsciousness against walls of testing chamber in attempt to escape the pain. Instance, SCP-092-175. Anomalous property. Listeners' bodies are pentasected radially, producing 5 disconnected segments, which remain alive and mobile. Instance SCP-092-176. Anomalous property. Listeners' bodies are pentasected laterally, producing 5 disconnected segments, which remain alive and mobile. Instance SCP-092-177. Anomalous property. Listeners' bodies are pentasected axially, producing 5 disconnected segments, which remain alive and mobile. Instance SCP-092-200. Anomalous property. Listeners are teleported to a site on the surface of Himalaya, the fifth most massive moon of Jupiter, fifth planet from the sun. Listeners are returned upon conclusion of CD, but succumb to the combined effects of hypothermia, hypoxia, and radiation poisoning within 3 hours. Requests have been made to use SCP-092-200 to send exploration teams equipped with environment suits to Himalaya. Approval is pending. Instance SCP-092-256. Anomalous property. Listeners are converted into 2-dimensional forms. Instance SCP-092-271. Anomalous property. Listeners spontaneously lose 5 teeth each. Teeth do not regrow after conclusion of CD. Instance SCP-092-272. Anomalous property. Listeners spontaneously lose all but 5 teeth each. Teeth do not regrow after conclusion of CD. Instance SCP-092-273. Anomalous property. Listeners spontaneously lose 5 fingernails each. Fingernails do not regrow after conclusion of CD. Instance SCP-092-274. Anomalous property. Listeners spontaneously lose 5 toenails each. Toenails do not regrow after conclusion of CD. Instance SCP-092-278. Anomalous property. Listeners spontaneously grow 3 extra eyes each, for a total of 5. Extra eyes do not dematerialize upon conclusion of CD. Eyes are functional and of the same color as listeners' original eyes. D-0927714, who had lost an eye in a fight prior to entering Foundation custody, grew 4 extra eyes when listening to SCP-092-278. Instance SCP-092-279. Anomalous property. Listeners experience topological deformation, such that their height becomes the circumference of their waist, and vice versa. Deformation reverts at conclusion of CD. This appears to be an exchange between listeners' dimension of height and dimension of width. Instance SCP-092-285. Anomalous property. Listeners sneeze 5 times per minute for the duration of the CD. Instance SCP-092-286. Anomalous property. Listeners belch 5 times per minute for the duration of the CD. Instance SCP-092-287. Anomalous property. Listeners hiccup 5 times per minute for the duration of the CD. Instance SCP-092-288. Anomalous property. Listeners cough 5 times per minute for the duration of the CD. Instance SCP-092-315. Anomalous property. Listeners find themselves within the 2010 Lars von Trier film Dimension, where they are able to interact with the setting but not affect the actions of the characters. Since Dimension is only 27 minutes in duration, the events within the film repeat 2.74 times. Instance SCP-092-316. Listeners find themselves within the 1993 EastEnders Doctor Who crossover, Dimensions in Time, where they are able to interact with the setting but not affect the actions of the characters. Since the two parts of Dimensions in Time are only 13 minutes in total duration, the events within the episodes repeat 5.69 times. Instance, SCP-092-317. Anomalous property. Listeners find themselves within the 1963 Italian film Amore in Quattro Dimensioni, where they are able to interact with the setting but not affect the actions of the characters. Instance, SCP-092-397. Anomalous property. Listeners experience random moments in the life of Alan Shepard, the fifth man to walk on the moon. Instance SCP-092-399. Anomalous property. Listeners experience random moments in the life of James Monroe, the fifth president of the United States. Instance SCP-092-400. Anomalous property. Listeners experience random moments in the life of Mackenzie Bowl, the fifth Prime Minister of Canada. Instance, SCP-092-401. Anomalous property. Listeners experience random moments in the life of Edward Sega, the fifth Prime Minister of Jamaica. Instance, SCP-092-402. Anomalous property. Listeners experience random moments in the life of Charan Singh, the fifth Prime Minister of India. Instance, SCP-092-403. Anomalous property. Listeners experience random moments in the life of Helen Hayes, the fifth winner of the Academy Award for Best Actress. Instance, SCP-092-466. Anomalous property. Listeners are physically transformed into members of the original lineup of the fifth dimension, as they were at the time of the group's establishment in 1966. Instance, SCP-092-467. Anomalous property. Listeners are physically transformed into members of the original lineup of the fifth dimension, as they were at the time of the original group's dissolution in 1975. Instance, SCP-092-468. Anomalous property. Listeners are physically transformed into members of the original lineup of the fifth dimension, as they were at the time of the original group's reunion in 1990. Instance, SCP-092-469. Anomalous property. Listeners are physically transformed into members of the original lineup of the fifth dimension, as they are today. Listeners who transform into Ron Townsend, 1933-2001, resume their original forms after conclusion of CD, but do not resurrect. When an instance of SCP-092 is inserted into the CD drive of a personal computer, its files can be accessed without triggering the anomalous effects. Examination of the files indicates that each CD has different content. All content is audio material by, or pertaining to, the fifth dimension and its individual members. In addition to all known commercially released songs, files contain live performances, practice sessions, auditions, media interviews, and personal conversations. Acquisition log. On May 5th, an unidentified man, henceforth SCP-092-B, carrying two suitcases, approached front gate guards at Site 19 and stated that he wished to surrender himself and his anomalous creations into Foundation custody. The contents of his suitcases were confiscated and classed as SCP-092. SCP-092-B was transferred to Site 37 for interrogation. During interrogation, SCP-092-B revealed the thematic connections, five dimensions, and the fifth dimension, between all instances of SCP-092, and then committed suicide. Transcript of statement made by SCP-092-B upon arrival at Site 19. Guard: Sir, this is private property, you can't... SCP-092-B: This is a secret Foundation site, right? Guard: You can't come in here, sir. I... SCP-092-B: You're the SCP Foundation, and I'm a failure. Guard: What was that, sir? SCP-092-B: You're the SCP Foundation, and I'm a failure. I think I'm clever, but I'm not. I'm a stupid, boring, knuckle-turning hack who thinks that money and cheap puns can take the place of talent and inspiration. I'm tasteless. I'm dull. I'm incompetent. I have no sense of style, and the only reason I'm not an art criminal is that nothing I've ever made is even close to being art. You can secure me, and you can contain me, but no one can protect me. Please take me and my anomalous garbage into custody. At this point, guards summoned backup. SCP-092-B repeated this statement verbatim until he was taken into custody. Excerpt from transcript of SCP-092-B interrogation session number 2. Interviewer: Yes, we understand about fiveness, thank you. That's been most helpful. But we were also wondering what you could tell us about how you made these. SCP-092-B: I just wanted to be cool, you know? I really did. I thought, well, I had my inheritance and my collection, and there was the estate and the abandoned museum, and so much of the stuff went together, and it wasn't that tough, and look, my ideas were better than yours. They were. I know they were. No, they're not. Nobody's impressed by this stupid facile wordplay. It's not even good wordplay. It's kindergarten-level paranomasia. Oh, look. Five dimensions. What other things can you think of that come in fives? I'm worthless. I'm worthless. Interviewer: Better than my ideas? SCP-092-B: There's no deeper meaning to what I did. It's all just superficial Potemkin Village crap pumping imitation shit into the river of human achievement. It's Stein's f***ing Oakland, and I don't even f***ing understand those f***ing illusions. I'm an uninspired wannabe. I'm boring. I'm a useless hack with no f***ing imagination. I've wasted and ruined miracles. I've squandered so much raw material that better people could have done so much with. I'm not cool. I never will be. I'm really sorry about the mess. These aren't my arms. At this point, SCP-092-B seized his own head with both hands and ripped it off his neck, killing himself instantly. Item number: SCP-061. Object class: Safe. Special containment procedures: The source code for SCP-061 is to be kept on a standard archival quality read-only data compact disk, or CD-ROM. 4 copies of the CD-ROM with the source code are to be stored in separate maximum security inanimate object lockers. Except for purposes of approved experimentation, SCP-061 is not to be loaded, compiled, or run. Research proposals for SCP-061 require written approval from Site Command. Only 1 copy of the CD-ROM containing the source code for SCP-061 may be used at a time. The CD-ROM is to be returned to storage immediately after having been used to load the source code for SCP-061 to a device. SCP-061 must never be loaded, compiled, or run on any device which has a connection to the internet, either directly or via another device. SCP-061 must never be loaded, compiled, or run on any device which is physically capable of wireless connectivity, regardless of whether that connectivity is in use. For purposes of approved experimentation, SCP-061 may be loaded, compiled, and run on a LAN consisting of no more than 3 devices plus peripherals. No devices are to be disconnected from the LAN during experimentation. Following the conclusion of experimentation, all devices within this LAN are to be immediately reformatted. Audio output peripherals for this LAN are to be contained within an observation chamber, surrounded with noise-canceling vacuum insulation. In the event of a perimeter breach by hostiles during SCP-061 experimentation, all devices within the LAN are to be immediately destroyed. Description: SCP-061 is an acoustic computer program being developed by SCP researchers, with the intent of producing successful countermeasures to similar programs being developed by governments and individuals around the world. Inspired by research on data expunged, SCP Command saw both the potential and harm in the ability to control the brain functions of other human beings. Laymen understand that music can elicit certain emotions and memories, or various sounds can elicit fear and excitement by simply being heard. Governments around the world have been attempting to expand on that premise for decades. SCP research is the first to elicit responses on higher mental activities. Parts of the brain affected by SCP-061 differ from those stimulated by data expunged or by subliminal messaging. Instead of acting on parts of the brain that are thought to be in control of the subconscious, acoustic frequencies produced by SCP-061 intercept conscious thoughts as they are produced and replace them. Instead of a suggestion, the human hearing center bisects the conscious thinking mind of the frontal lobe with the motor control cortical homunculus of the brain. A baseline rhythm convinces the rest of the brain that the conscious mind is asleep and effectively stops conscious thought from continuing to the rest of the brain. In return, the frontal lobe experiences a pause that resembles the psychological effects of anesthesia. Acoustic codes developed by SCP-061 are interpreted by motor centers in the brain as conscious instructions, and the subject typically acts accordingly. Subjects will normally have a blank facial expression while under the influence of SCP-061. They are not responsive to attempts at conversation and express no desires, such as hunger or interest in sexual advances. Though all commands are followed without question, the effects of the auditory control cease once the subject is no longer able to hear the program. Most test subjects report being unable to remember the actions they performed while under control, but a few had experienced the effect of watching helplessly as their body acted against their will. The intent of such research is to discover ways to counteract the effects of auditory mind control. However, only two methods of countermeasures have proven successful as of yet. 1. The subject's hearing is impaired so that the individual can no longer hear the program, either by covering the ear or deafening the subject. 2. The program itself sends a coded instruction to the hearing center of the brain, permanently shutting it down. Though the ear continues to hear, there has been no progress in finding the proper code to reboot the hearing center of the brain. Addendum 01. All subjects are placed under auditory control, issued a coded auditory command, and then monitored. Subject 4402F. Command: sleep. Response: subject curled up into a fetal position on the floor, and her brain began emitting alpha waves associated with sleep. Her eyes remained wide open in the typical blank, empty expression associated with controlled subjects, but her eyes twitched rapidly in ways associated with REM sleep. Subject 4427M. Command: run on treadmill. Response: subject mounted treadmill and then proceeded to run. Subject did not turn on the treadmill, resulting in the subject impacting the control platform. Subject repeated this until the stop command was issued. Note: more detailed commands are advised for task-oriented commands. Subject 4427M. Command: turn treadmill on. Run on treadmill. Response: subject turned on the treadmill to maximum speed, mounted, and attempted to run before being ejected off the conveyor belt. Subject repeatedly attempted to turn on the treadmill to a random speed and run on it, with various outcomes. Note: more detailed commands are advised for task-oriented commands. Subject 4427M. Command: turn on treadmill to jogging speed. Jog on treadmill. Response: subject successfully jogged on treadmill until stop command was issued, which resulted in subject being ejected off the conveyor belt. Note: subject should be in a safe neutral position before stop commands are issued. Lesson complete. To continue with your orientation training, subscribe to SCP Orientation right now and make sure you don't miss any of our upcoming videos.